Welcome to the one video that will take you from data newbie to data cleaning pro on Excel using 8 steps. Let's go. So let's suppose we're analysts at Amazon and we've been given this data set over here, which you can actually download for free in the video description. So you can see we have all of our customers here, including what brand they bought from and the price they paid for it. And so our manager would like us to clean this raw set of data before we send it to him. As the first step, let's work on separating the contact into the first name and the last name. So you can see over here that we have it with an underscore tied together. So what we're gonna do is add 2 more columns. So control space for that, and then control shift plus again. So one of these is gonna be the first and the second one, the last name. So as you can see over here, we need to somehow separate it. And for this, we'll use the text to columns feature. Now to do so, we're just gonna select all of the contacts here. So just control shift down all the way till you get to the bottom here. So around row 26 it should be. Then we're just gonna go over to data. From here, we'll go to text to columns that you can find right over here under data tools. So just click inside that. And I know this looks a bit daunting, but just go ahead and hit next for now. And so over here, the delimiter is basically gonna be the criteria that we separate by. In our case, we seem to have this underscore all around, so we probably want to go with that. We're just going to click on other there, and here's where we'll type the underscore. And once we do that, you can see down below how it's going to get separated like so. So we'll just go to next from there. And then as a destination, let's put it under here where it says first and hit enter there. Once we have that, we're just going to go to finish. And just like that, you can see that it's now been separated into first name and last name. Awesome, now that looks a lot cleaner. After that, let's get going on the brand column. So if we look over here, you can see that we have all of these different brands. But actually, when we look closely at them, you can see that Nike, Nike Inc., and Nike UK should actually be just labeled the same thing, as after all, they're all Nike. So if we wanted to get the sum of all the Nike sales, well, these wouldn't be accounted for, and so it wouldn't be entirely accurate. So we need to somehow try to clean that up. So the first step we'll do here is try to find out which exactly are the unique ones. So we're just gonna use the unique formula, so equals unique, hit the tab key there, and we're gonna select all of the brands from here. So control shift down, make sure you reach all the way to the bottom here, and then hit enter. And just like that, you can see all of the different ones that we have. And so for Nike, you can see that we have Nike Inc. and Nike UK, which should just be Nike. Now, to be able to work with this one, we're gonna actually just hit the Control H. And what we're gonna do here is this is gonna replace things for us. So wherever it says Nike Inc., we want it to be replaced with just Nike. And same thing goes with Nike UK. So find what? We say find Nike Inc. Make sure you put the dot in the end. And we wanna replace it with just plain Nike. And we're gonna go to replace all just below over here. Just click on that. And you can see it's made one replacement. We'll hit OK there. And same thing goes with the Nike UK. So find what? We're gonna change that to Nike UK and replace with Nike. Hit replace all, hit OK there, and hit close. And that should do it for us. We can now go ahead and delete this whole column over here. So now if we go back to the brands over here, you can see that it's been replaced to just plain Nike instead of being Nike Inc. or Nike UK. Now that we've cleaned up the brand part, let's take a closer look at the products and how that can be cleaned up. As you can see over here, it's looking quite messy in that there's capital letters in somewhat inconsistent places, so it makes it kind of hard to read. So for this, we're just gonna create a new column here. So control space and then control shift plus here. Let's name this product as well. Product clean, say. And down over here, what we're gonna use is a simple formula called proper, so equals proper. You can see the description for it here, and what it's gonna do is it's gonna convert this such that we only have a capital letter as the first letter within a word. So hit the tab key, select this, and just hit enter there, and you can see that it just has a capital letter on the M and the S. And just double click that so it goes down all the way to the bottom here. Next up, we've got the location of each customer. And as of now, it seems to be that there's a ton of different spaces around them. So we wanna also try to clean that up. So we'll go over here and select a new column again. So control space and then control shift plus. Here, let's name this location clean. And what we want to do here is use the trim function, which is going to remove all of the excess spaces that seem to be the case all across this file here. So we'll go equals, trim, hit the tab key there. This is a text. We'll close it and hit enter there. And again, we'll just double click here once that cursor is kind of black here, and just double click like so. And if you're liking this exercise and want more extensive Excel material, you can check out our Excel for Business and Finance course, where we teach everything we know about Excel, specifically for people either looking to break into a business or a finance role, or those in it trying to level up their Excel game. And what makes this course different is that it's all applied to the real world. While we still cover the theoretical lessons like formatting, formulas, and charts, we also offer case studies that simulate the type of work you might be assigned in your day-to-day, ranging from financial modeling to cleaning a complex data set and presenting some visual insights. On top of that, we also offer several other courses, including PowerPoint, valuation, and more. So if you're interested in checking it out, you can go to the link in the description below. All right, back to the video. Now that we've worked on the spacing issue with the location where we had too many spaces, let's now work to separate the city name and the country name for further analysis. So over here, we're just gonna press Control Space and then Control Shift Plus and Control Shift Plus again. And so here, let's say we go by city and then we're gonna go by country. And this time around, instead of using text to columns like before, we'll use the flash fill. So here, I'm just gonna type London. And over here, I'm just gonna type UK. From here, all we need to do is hit Control E and Control E again. And just like that, you can see that we have all of the cities auto-populated. And same thing goes with the countries over here. Next up, let's work on the fulfillment column and actually making it a percentage. As you can see over here, under fulfillment percentage, we just have the number as of now. So what happens is that when I change this to percentage format, you can either go to home and then click on that percentage, or the shortcut is just Alt-HP. You can see that it gives us 3000%, which isn't exactly accurate. Instead, it should just be 30%. So press Ctrl-Z there to go back to how it was. We're gonna need to fix this. So to do so, we're gonna use basically, we're just gonna have to put 100 over here to the side. And then what we'll do is, once we have that 100 selected, we'll press Control C. And down over here under fulfillment percentage, we're just gonna select all of them. Make sure it's all the way till the end there, so till row 26. What you wanna do is go to Paste Special. So go to Control Alt V. And you can see that the Paste Special pop-up shows up over here. What we want to do is go under operation, and we want to multiply it, we want to divide it, sorry, by 100. So just click on that divide there and hit OK. Now you can see that we have it formatted the right way to switch to percentage. So now when we just do Alt HP to switch to percentage, you can see that it's now looking accurate. Moving on to one of the last steps, and over here under price, you can see that as of now, so we have all of the prices, but there seems to be something odd in that when I select multiple, you can see that we don't actually get the sum or the average like I might when I select all of these over here to the side. You can see that we get the average and the sum. And so to test that out, let's say I go equals, hit this price and say plus one. And oddly enough, it gives me a value sign. And that seems to be because this as of now is not formatted as a number. So we're gonna need to manipulate it. So first things first, you can see that we have a comma in there. That should actually really be a dot instead of a comma. So we're gonna go equals substitute. So we'll basically replace that comma for a dot. So hit the tab key there. Let's just move this to the side a bit. And this is gonna be the text, comma. And so in the old text, what we wanna do is in quotations, we're gonna put the comma there and then hit a comma this time to go to the new text. Under the new text, quotations again, and we'll put a dot. Then we're just gonna close the quotations and hit enter. So you can see that we went from the comma to the dot. Let's just drag that down for now. And there is one more step that we need to take. As you can see, if I highlight these two, I still don't get the sum over here or the average. So what we're gonna do is this time around, go to value, hit the tab key. And so this is a text, and let's just hit enter there. And this time it should be as a number. So we'll drag that down, and now you can finally see that we have the average and the sum calculated as it should be the case. And one final thing you might have noticed is that we have some rows with blank data. So let's look into that. But first, before we get into there, let's actually label these two. So let's say I label this one price one and this here price final. So once we have this, if we scroll all the way to the right here, to the left, sorry, you'll notice that we see all of these that are blank. Same thing goes up over here. Now, the reason this is problematic is because maybe the data here is not reliable. Let's suppose that we make the decision that we want to delete those rows that have some missing data, as we can't really work with them that well. Now, we could go one by one, try to find it and delete it. But the problem is, if this is a very large data set, then that's obviously not very realistic. So instead, what we'll do is first select the entire table by hitting Control A. Then we'll go Control G under this Go To pop-up that should show up for you. We're gonna go down towards the bottom where it says Special. So we'll click on that. Then over here, we wanna identify the blanks. So that's gonna be this thing over here. Make sure you tick on that, hit OK. From here, you can see that it's highlighted all of the blank areas for us. Once we have those, we can simply press Control minus. Under delete here, we don't just want the shift cells left. What we want is the entire row to be deleted. Hit OK there. And just like that, we're not gonna have any more blank cells. So all our data here, we can actually work with. Now that you know how to clean the data, you should learn how to visualize it with this video over here to create an awesome dashboard, or this other link over here to check out our Excel course. Hit that like and that subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next one.